How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to another show. This is You May Roscoe, and I am he. And today I'm here with my partner in crime. I got Peeps in the building with me. What up with it, bro?
What's going on, Roscoe? What's going on, Roscoe Nation?
Ain't nothing to it. You know, just another day in the neighborhood, man. Today it looked like we're going to be checking out some wrestling, the actual match. You know, I know me and you, we had talked off camera. A lot about wrestling. We are both wrestling fans from different eras, you know what I mean? I thought that this would give us a chance, you know, for me and you, there's roughly about a decade separating us. So I felt like this would be a match that you probably wouldn't be familiar with. And probably the next time when everybody else on YouTube sees us, they'll probably see me and you doing it. A match that I'm not familiar with and you are. So this time we're doing the Fabulous Freebirds versus the Von Erichs. And are you familiar with either group?
I know of them. I know of them, and I know that that's one of the biggest rivalries in wrestling like that.
Right, right.
But to actually see one of their matches, no. But I do know of them, though.
Okay. No, that'll be dope. So before we get into it, I do want to ask for anybody who hasn't already that they please subscribe to the channel. Also, make sure you hit the notification bell. That way you'll be reminded of every single time any future shows pop up. And now me and Peeps, we're going to go ahead and get into this. Now, I'm excited. You know, I don't even know if I've seen this one. I'm pretty sure I haven't because... for me, I don't even think I was into wrestling. This may be a little early for me. I don't even think I'm in double digits. I'm roughly around 10 at the time, but I don't think I've really touched into my wrestling stage until about a year and a half later or something. But this would be good to watch, you know, so we'll see what's up with it. That's one of the BS. That's one of the BS. That's one of the BS. That man was a full-blown rock star, dude. That man was a full-blown rock star, dude.
I mean, just look at the hair, man. Just look at the hair. I mean... You don't need to say nothing else, man. Just look at that hair, man.
Yeah, no, dude. It's like David Lee Roth. This is, you know what I mean? This is Axl Rose. This is this is all that wrapped in the one, man. Oh, yeah. Man. I love PS, man.
Here they are, led by Michael Hayes. Already on this show, you see the premiere of the video that goes with this Bad Street Brawl. As Freebirds, Terry Gordy, and Buddy Roberts follow Hayes into the ring with the world.
I'm not going front, man. I love the Freebirds. Two-thirds of them. Like I love Bam Bam. Love Bam Bam Terry Gordy. Love Michael P.S. Hayes. The third guy, Buddy, whatever his name is, man. Oh. And it's gotta be one of those in every group, but he was dead. Every time I saw him, it's like, man, y'all got two dudes like them and then this guy. You know. You know, but hey, maybe I shouldn't have said that. I should have, you know, but every time I see that dude, when I get a chance to see the Freebirds, I'm like, why is he with it?
Right. Somebody's cousin.
And what a trophy it is. What a level. Hey, dancing to his music. And now the song changes. the fans begin to cheer, and here comes the monitor.
Dude without the boots on, I believe that's Kevin Von Erich, you know, if I got it right. But that, I used to love the dude without him and Kerry. I love Kerry Von Erich, but, and that's not him right there. I forget which brother that is. They had like a trillion Von Erichs. And all of them died, you know, tragically, you know, sadly.
Wow.
Yeah, a shit ton of them. It's really crazy story behind that. But yeah, like more than a few of them, like, committed, you know, the ultimate act on themselves.
Oh, wow.
You know, you know, getting away from that, though, the wrestlers, you know, they right. were amazing. They were amazing. So let's keep that going.
Is they come as you are. Fans streak out. Whatever you wear into the ring can be used. Notice the Freebirds in blue jeans. Jordy and Roberts with big leather belts and steel buckles.
That's
boots. And here come the Von Erichs. By Kevin and Fitz, but look out, it's broken boots. Broken boots already. They'll try to restrain the Freebirds and get Fritz, Kevin, and Mike back to the ring. This is an electrifying experience for all involved, as Fritz Von Erich has returned to Texas Stadium, where he retired for this one time only, to team with his boys. And look at it, Fritz Handel Hayes. Fritz in his wrestling boots, jeans and shirt with a belt of his own, and Hayes thrown to the floor.
They had pops in there. They had Fritz in there, man. And like, he was a part of the match. He was signed on as the third dude, I believe.
Right. This is like Tom and Jerry, man. This is like an episode of like Tom and Jerry. Like they couldn't even get in the ring, man. It was, as soon as I see their eyes, attack.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I like that.
Yeah, no. They take no prisoners immediately. You know what I mean? So yeah, no, but that's how you sell a rivalry. You know what I mean? Like you gotta make it like, boy, it's on sight. You know what I mean? Like, and that's how it used to be, like, back in the days. It wasn't all that, like, we could sit and have promos and all that with each other all the time. I'm like, dude, man, when I see you, it's on.
Right. You know?
There's Jordy over the top rope. And bail out. Jordy with a chair. Are flying here at Texas Stadium. Here's David Manning.
Listen up. There's no rules in this match, but there's one rule we're going to enforce. It's a tag team match. Only one of you comes in the ring, and that's the way it's going to be. There'll be two people in the ring at once. No six man. And if you don't,
the rules have been laid down. The gauntlet has been laid.
Like it.
And they're at the old Texas Stadium too.
Is that where they at? Well, they must be in. So yeah, no, Texas got it looked like a very huge place.
Yep.
Yeah. So Texas, they do it big. So.
Still two against three. It's going to be one-on-one in the ring, and you can tag in and out. And that goes for the Von Erich, too. You understand?
Why wouldn't they go?
David Manning reminded all parties concerned that there will be rules in this bout, and it is a tag team bout. One man at a time from each team. The world six-man title. Next to the world title, most prestigious belt in all of the world. And it's even wilder today being a bad street belt. Meaning whatever you wear into the ring.
That's a lot of posturing. that's a lot of posturing going on. We see how long that lasts. I don't want to miss nothing on you.
Kevin Von Erich already bleeding from one of the chairs or something of that nature. And here we go. The bell is sounded. It's Roberts against Kevin. Oh, Roberts really hit hard in the corner. And Kevin, there's Hayes in now.
He just told you to win.
This is going to be a tough spot to control.
He just told them the rules. Why is they like 30 seconds in, like not listening?
Right. You know what I say? It's like Tom and Jerry up in there, man.
Dude, this shit is nuts, man. But they threw the weak link up in there first. I swear I did not like that dude. Like.
He was the guy that always got worked over for the hot tag, you know?
Oh, yeah. No, and dude, as a kid, I didn't know no better. You know what I mean? So I'm just thinking like all the time, like, dude, why is this weak dude with them? He always get whooped in there. But then once you understand the business and understand how necessary he was, you know what I mean? But just real talk though, like I forget you probably know peeps, like the official name for like those dudes who they really just sent out there to get beat up to lose matches, you know.
Jobbers.
Yeah, I think it's something like that. Yeah, but those dudes, they necessary, like very necessary. So shout out to the jobbers of the world. Necessary, I suppose.
Kevin nails Gordy, who is over there in the wrong corner where he shouldn't be. Roberts, with both hands clenched, nails Kevin from behind. Kevin nursing that finger that cut open, drop kicks, or rather, clean Roberts out of the corner. Kevin wrestling barefooted, puts in Mike in boots. All of the Freebirds in Western-style boots with a pointed toe. What a thrill this is for Mike Von Erich, who's in the ring now to be able to team with his father, the legend, the greatest wrestler we've ever seen, Fritz Von Erich. Mike drops down.
Never had the pleasure of seeing Mike Von Erich wrestle, I don't think. I thought that was David Von Erich. But it was a trillion of them. It's sad to say, Mike probably took himself away, because I'm telling you, like, a good number of these dudes, like, a lot of them wrestled, and a lot of them did the same thing, ended the same way.
What?
It's like a curse or something. I don't know what's going on, the Von Erich curse, but yeah, I've never seen Mike Von Erich. I've seen David, I've seen Kerry, I've seen, of course, Fritz, and what is it? I'm gonna lose track. It's too many Von Erichs. I remember even a skinny kid Von Erich that they threw out there. Like, dude, y'all know, and I think he did himself in too, because he just fell into the he wasn't even supposed to be wrestling. He didn't have a wrestler body or nothing.
Right. It was their 12-year-old's cousin that they just needed for a night, and he's just like, you know what? I'm just here, man. I'm just here.
They like, no, you a Von Erich is what you is.
Cool. Man, get your ass in that ring, man.
When I was your age, you know what I mean? Nobody went to school. We went right to wrestling school. That's what we went. Went to school to wrestle.
Out of that leg and locks up the foot and toe. The largest crowd ever to see wrestling anywhere in the world is on hand here at Texas Stadium today, and I'm afraid to put a figure on it. But could be anywhere between 35 and 50,000. Look at Roberts hold Mike Von Erich down as Hayes stomps him across the face of those boots. How can anyone stand the punishment? There's the body slam. Hayes goes to the corner. Look out. My God, Eric out of the way. Here comes Frank. The crowd leaps for his feet. They're standing at Texas Stadium. Handles Michael Hayes.
How you feel about Fritz being out there?
I mean, that's old school, man. You know what I'm saying? you see the way he's setting them up, and literally his the power of his blows is sending Michael Hayes flat on his back. If he misses with one of those blows, Michael Hayes will get a cold and die of pneumonia. That's how powerful his blows are out there, man. It's
dude, you better stop humbling. Don't play around with that old man strength.
Oh man, yo, man, clearly, man. You know, but no, it's really cool to see him out there doing his thing.
Yeah, oh, Fritz, it was so it was like actually fun. Like every time I remember Fritz being out there, it was just like he's not supposed to be out there. But it was good. It was always fun.
Carlson Kevin is there. Fritz takes off his belt. Mike Von Erich holds Hayes. It's time to go to the woodshed. Look at Fritz. Holy cow, look at
that's what they do in Texas, baby. That's those are the one white people that you can't accuse of like hey, no, they're talking about they don't whoop their kids. Yeah.
All right.
Okay, not in Texas.
Clearly. Clearly.
Get Hayes run. Absolutely indescribable. It's going to be a square off now between Kevin Von Erich and Freebird Terry Gordy. Texas Stadium's Parade of Champions here on World Class Championship Wrestling. I'm Arthur Ransom. Go first of the day. You're watching the World Six-Man Title Bad Street Style. The fabulous Freebird versus Von Erich, and that means Fritz today for one time only. Kevin Von Erich with blood on his white trousers. Very good drive by Terry Gordy on Kevin Von Erich.
That's what I'm talking about.
Fritz, not interested in officiating. Remember now, if the Von Erichs win this bout.
I also did not like that. Bam Bam is one of the toughest dudes. He's known as one of the toughest dudes in wrestling history. and Fritz was giving it to him.
The ability to sell is so critical. It makes all the difference.
It makes all the fucking difference, apparently. You know what I mean? Like, it just goes to show you how the dedication to the craft. Dedication, man, because I don't know, man. Like you got to take pride out of it too. You know what I mean? Like you tell some young 20-something year old dude, I'm assuming he's maybe 30-something at the time or whatever he is, probably older, who knows? But he was young, he was younger than Fritz. You know what I mean? So you have to go and tell him, like, hey, you're gonna be in this match and Fritz gonna give you something a little bit. And you gotta be okay with that. So I don't know. But, you know, he did it. You know, shout out to Bam Bam for that.
Terry steps in to take Fritz's place. Here's Gordy. Kevin with a drive on Freebird Terry Gordy in the corner. A rough, tough bout. Flying there, Kevin out. He wants that iron claw that only the Von Erichs know.
I forgot about that move.
Gordy holds it off best he can. 5 minutes. Now Foley informing us there are 5 minutes gone in this bout. Here's Kevin to the rope. Clothesline. Michael Hayes taking off the boot.
That's a Mike Turner shit right there. He go I turn on the man back. Oh shit.
Michael Hayes is taking off that boot and smashing it over the head. He can crack a head open with that boot. This is all legal. Remember, Kerry steps in, said the Von Erichs win. To take Fritz's place.
Pete, what was that move?
He did. He did. It's the power of the sale, man.
Dude, dude, what was that move?
I thought he just hit him with his belly, man.
That's what it looked like. I don't think I've ever seen that before. I don't know if I've ever seen that.
That open with that boot. This is all legal. Remember, Kerry steps in, said the Von Erichs win to take Fritz's place.
He hit him with his belt buckle.
Gotcha. Okay, that makes sense now.
I had to process that for a second.
Because I'm like, okay, he belly rushed him? Like, okay.
Dude, that almost it almost felt like we was in sus.
Right. It was borderline one of those sus moments.
We was there again. It looked like we still there. I don't know. Let's see.
There's Roberts hitting him over the head with that belt buckle as he throws his midsection forward, allowing that steel belt buckle to go into Kevin's head. Here comes Fritz and look at Roberts. Fritz in the corner. The crowd again coming to its feet, but Hayes comes over. Gordy is there. It's mayhem. Fritz now, he wants another piece of Michael Hayes who's bleeding. Fritz Von Erich has the art called Michael.
I forgot that was a family thing. Like you inherit the claw.
the claw. Nice. The claw.
It's the family heirloom.
And you are seeing it right here. The famous Fritz Von Erich hardcore is now on Roberts too. Can you believe it?
Old man strength, baby.
He double clawing the ass.
Don't doubt old man strength ever.
Yep, now let that be a lesson to you kids. And not only that, you know, the power of a simple move, you know, such as the claw. Or the bionic elbow, you know, in wrestling. Man, simple is better.
Where did those go, peeps? Where did those simple moves go? Like, I used to love the bionic elbow. Like, you couldn't tell me nothing about that elbow wasn't bionic for me.
Right. Was he the first, you know, $1 million man? You know what I'm saying? $10 million man, was that Lee Majors?
The $6 million man. Yeah.
Was he the $1 million man before that? You know, was he the prototype? We don't know.
Right, we don't know. You know what I mean? Like he was all bionic. You know what I mean?
Right.
You know, like not all. I think mostly bionic, but you know what I mean? Like old homie shit. He just had the elbow. You know what I mean? So and. You know, the family heirloom right here is going strong with Fritz. So two people in Iron Claws at the same time. That's very believable.
The Von Erich Iron Claw Now here's Gordy, and he's got his boot and is slicing it over Fritz's head. Gordy on Fritz, Hayes on Mike. Open up. Hayes is covered in blood. Yeah. And Mike and Fritz throw the Freebirds right into each other, head first. Fritz Von Erich wants the iron claw again on Robertson. Mike with his boot on Terry Gordy. Again.
Oh, wow.
No, look out. It's Mike Von Erich thrown into Roberts. Kevin with a splice from the corner. He was out on the floor. Hey! Von Erich wins.
See which one they pinned. You see who they pinned, right?
That was a beautiful crossbody.
No, it was. He flew a long way, too.
Yeah.
But you see, they caught the weak link.
And not only that, but didn't the ref tell his ass? It was only supposed to be one person in the goddamn match. More than half this match has been all everybody just fighting, just an all-out brawl.
Nobody said he didn't even say nothing. The dude who laid throughs.
Exactly. The ref did all that tough talk. Only for these guys to be like, oh, okay. Yeah. And you know what led everybody to the brawl?
What's that?
Is old man Von Erich.
Yeah.
Every time he touched the ring, it went into a run.
It go up. Yep. He's a whole turn up by itself.
Exactly.
He's a whole turn up. So yeah, no, that, and from my memory, like that's how it went. Like if you saw Fritz, it was